Hello friends, in the series on the income tax cases, today we will discuss a matter, and the matter is related to the interest on refunds which are due to the assessee. As all we know that the rate of interest prescribed under section 244A subsection 1 is 0.5% of the refund amount. Can assessee claim that the refund due to the assessee is a judgment debt when the refund is ordered by the court, and can file a writ petition for claiming the rate of interest at a higher rate of interest, that is 18%. This issue has been taken by Madhya Pradesh High Court in a writ petition filed by the assessee for claiming higher rate of interest in the case of Gurmeet Singh Wilku versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax and another. This case has been reported in 466 ITR at page number 56, and the matter has been decided by Madhya Pradesh High Court on 9th February 2024. In the present case, the assessee is an employee of a bank and has been placed under suspension in a department inquiry and ultimately terminated. The assessee went to the court and the High Court quashed termination order and kept the employee under suspension and also passed an order to give a subsistence allowance to the assessee. According to this order, the bank calculated the subsistence allowance at a figure of ₹20,90,000 and deducted a TDS of ₹5,25,000 and paid the amount to the assessee. The assessee filed rectification application under section 154 for claiming the relief under section 89 subsection 1. But the assessing officer rejected the rectification application under section 154 and denied the relief under section 89 subsection 1. The assessee filed the writ petition in the Madhya Pradesh High Court, and Madhya Pradesh High Court said that the assessee is very much entitled to relief under section 89 subsection 1, and accordingly gave the order to give the refund to the assessee and the allowable interest also under section 244A subsection 1. The revenue gave the refund to the assessee. The refund was calculated near about ₹2,81,797, and the interest at the rate of 0.5% was given. Now the assessee in the third round of litigation was not happy with the rate of interest, and he was of the view that since the High Court has ordered for giving the interest to the assessee, so that order should be treated as a judgment debt and the assessee is entitled to simple interest on refund, and so the assessee filed another writ petition in the High Court for claiming the interest at the rate of 18%. When the Madhya Pradesh High Court heard the writ petition for giving the higher rate of interest to the assessee, the High Court was of the view that when the rate of interest is given in a statute and the rate of interest is 0.5%, so in that case the assessee cannot ask for a higher rate of interest, because the Madhya Pradesh High Court, when allowing the relief application of the assessee, has said that the assessee should be given the allowable interest, and the allowable interest is 0.5%. So in that case, it cannot be said that the interest is not calculated as per the directions issued by the court in assessee's earlier writ petition. So the conclusion of the case is that when the High Court has said that the assessee should be allowed allowable interest, so as per the view of the High Court, the allowable interest is 0.5%, and whatever the interest has been given to the assessee is as per Income Tax Act section 244A subsection 1. But in some cases it has been seen that where the revenue has upheld the refund of the assessee for unnecessarily very long period with no fault of the assessee, and the assessee is being run from pillar to post to claim the refund. In that cases, some courts have allowed higher rate of interest also, but in that case, some mistake is on the part of the revenue in delaying the refunds. But in the present case, this was not the case. At the end of this video, once again, I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Gurmeet Singh Wilku versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax and another. And this case has been reported in 466 ITR at page number 56. And the matter has been decided by Madhya Pradesh High Court on 9th of February 2024. Thank you, friends.